गुड आफ्टरनून लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन. सो आई एम द सीईओ एंड फाउंडर ऑफ एडम. सो एडम इज बेसिकली अ कंपनी दैट एआई बेस्ड कंपनी इज पुटिंग एफर्ट इन क्लोजिंग द गैप बिटवीन योर ऑनलाइन एफर्ट एंड हाउ यू डिड पर्सनलाइजेशन ऑन योर ऑफलाइन स्टोर्स और वेन यू इंटरैक्ट विद द कस्टमर. So I guess most of you are aware of the customer acquisition process. Many of your brand custodians are already putting a lot of efforts in acquiring customers through digital advertising, paid ads, programmatic, connecting, generating leads, giving them to the CRM team, then retaining your customers, and also how to basically get more sales from the same customer again and again. So, AI is a very hyped topic now these days, and I'm sure that will stay. So most of the times, there are difference between high performance marketeers and low performance marketeers. The difference lies between who adopt the technology first. So there's been surveys done across the globe, and which shows that the high performance teams basically are likely to adapt technology faster and quicker than low performance marketing teams, which can be up to 10 times. Okay, so I guess a lot of you guys know, maybe doing online lead generation for your brands, and if the leads are generated, how they're going to tackle it, how the sales team is going to tackle it if the leads are coming. The experience you're creating digitally, how can you take that to an offline experience as well? That also includes stores, your experience centers, your hotels, your say showrooms. So you are generating online leads through campaigns. So there is an AI method basically which optimizes your campaign. So in the starting of this session, we have heard that in every marketer, there's a problem where they do not know which are the right platform they should advertise on, right? Now, with the use of AI and ML, and I always say this, marketing and advertising is not more by gut, it's more maths and science, right? Which creative will work online? It doesn't matter how good you are in terms of guessing it, but it's rather a number that speaks itself, right? So you know it beforehand if this creative will work for me or not. What kind of an audience will be my say, online effort on which platform? So you will never know before you will put it on the test. So there is an AI method which knows, so you are already collecting a lot of data online, which is like another in terms of numbers, and you are basically feeding it to the ML, which decides itself which ad need to be shown to which people online. Then these leads, when you generate these online, you pass on this to the CRM system, and the CRM system basically, you have a manual team which basically verifies your quality of the leads you generate. This effort should go automatically into your CRM system, and then you find out the right customers who will approach you to your stores. You invite them to your experience centers, to your showrooms, maybe to your car showrooms as well. So think about this process. If you're generating leads online, you see a lot of your customers are already doing a lot of research about you online. They know when will you launch, what were the shortcomings of this product, how many showrooms you have. They know about the brand much more than you know about the customers. Think about that. If your sales team have the power, they know each and every walk-in customer, more information about your customers rather than just talking to any random visitor at the store. You can give personalized attention to each and every customer who are visiting or who have filled an online inquiry form, and you can pass on the same experience to that guy. And how is that possible? This is possible if somebody is generating, filling online inquiry onto your website. You basically, so you collect most of the public data, available data for that lead. That also includes social media profiles, pictures, where they work, things like this. And what they were choosing on, what they are selecting on your website, where they're clicking, what is the choice of preference, what they're buying on your website. When they come to your store, you give them a personalized services, right? Like identifying VIP customers, right? Giving them specific discounts, right? When they approach you, you give them specific discounts. Okay, so now think about this thing. So if you can collect the information about your customers, and if there's the technology, you can upload it to some cameras present in the stores, which are more like AI-enabled cameras. Think about this, somebody filling an online lead, right? And that guy comes to your store. He doesn't need to tell a whole story, what kind of product he's interested in, what kind of, say, discussions he had with your CRM team, and why he's invited. For example, a guy walks in, say, it's a random example, walks to a car showroom, he's a Skoda, and he's interested in Super. So he's interested in a Super car. He should not come and tell every time that he has an online inquiry form, he's called or to the showroom to show the car, and he does not need to tell every time who that person is, what his interests are, and should not be keep on waiting. Think about this, if the person is treated like a VIP at the Skoda showroom in a specific lounge area, right? So there are multiple methods you can track your online initiative and track it to the offline. But there is no solid example for this. Think about this, what kind of people pick? Let's say somebody coming to your store, you can give them a particular kind of specific service. When they come up, you can personally greet them, give them a specific shopping assistance. They can pick up what products they like. There are a lot of brands who are basically want to know more about their customers, giving them more personalized services, right? Say they also want to know what kind of random people who just appear at the store, right? What kind of products they pick? Can they show them that specific ads to those people online as well, right? The product they have not bought offline, can they also try them online? So this is how Adam is working in terms of utilizing multiple technologies, and there are multiple methods. There are hardly no methods actually available. Without the use of AI, we can track who is coming, what kind of leads we are generating online, and how we are tracking that leads to the offline stores. So building that gap bridging that gap between online to offline is really, really impossible these days. But use of AI and ML, using artificial intelligence like video analytics, know more about your audience well before they enter your store is the thing that what next is coming into marketing, right? Just optimizing your Google, Facebook, or Instagram does not help anymore. You need conversion. Business needs food on the plate. That what I mean is like, businesses need revenue. They do not want to spend extra budgets or funds on the marketing side. They need also to know about more about their customers. So just putting money in marketing is not helping these days. Even to know about your customers, giving personalized services, showing them personalized ads, basically help you bridge the gap between online and offline, helps you reduce the cost on your marketing budgets big time, right? We are talking about 30% reduction in your marketing wastage as well. And also giving personalized service. I was talking to a person, and they told me they want to buy a property, and they filled an online inquiry form, and they went and visited the property site, and they were interested in buying a premium property. The irony is, they went there, they have to explain the whole story again, and she has to wait like 10-15 minutes, and she was getting late, and nobody was basically able to connect her to the right person. What if that lady arrives at the center, and you know that who the lady is, you can recognize that at the entrance of that location and give her a personalized service or welcome or a bouquet, and the right person approaches the person immediately. So this is how we will be able to use AI in terms of bridging the gap between online and offline. Yeah, this is it. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. It was nice.